rooftop. This incredible bedroom set is worth over $4,500.
Renee, what do you think about your new furniture?
I love it!
You too love it. Your husband's there. You love it too, right? Okay. Thank you to our friends at Aaron's. You can shop at your local Aaron's store or at Aaron's.com. They make owning easy so you can own the life you want. Renee, enjoy your new bedroom.
Thank you.
Like to win a room in June, log on to WendyShow.com. Eye candy is next. Come on, let's go.
For decades, we've been working to make this possible. Engineers, programmers, technicians, more than 20 years of nonstop development. It's an honor to present Aaron's.com.
A website?
This is a website where people can own with no credit needed. Now millions can own top brands with affordable monthly payments online. And just $25 gets you started, whether you lease to own in-store or at the new Aaron's.com.
Closed captioning is provided by...
New Dickinson's Original Witch Hazel Cleansing Cloths. Cleanse, tone, and refresh. Dickinson's, the best-kept beauty secret since 1866. For special offers, visit Walgreens today.
You're up this early because you want to squeeze a little more out of your day.
I'm busy during the day. I want to know what the traffic conditions are.
WPTV Time Saver Traffic with the only local chopper covering your neighborhood.
They're going to alert me of any traffic conditions so that I can replan my route to work.
A first-hand look at traffic jams so you don't have to guess.
You get an aerial view of the entire area.
Chopper 5, Time Saver Traffic, the only morning traffic team. Today on 5 on WPTV News Channel 5.
Fire now!
Nice work! I could kiss you!
I would accept that with an open mouth.
Start the summer with the best comedy of the year.
We're gonna seduce him.
You're eating a hand towel.
Just cleansing my palate.
Spy. Put it on. Tomorrow. Feel like a kid again with Dunkin's new Oreo and Chips Ahoy flavored iced coffees. Classic cookie flavor in every sip. America runs on Dunkin'.
Make tomorrow awesome with Xfinity Internet from Comcast. Call 1-800-880-7171 today. And do what you love online with Xfinity Internet for only $19.99 a month for 12 months. Xfinity Internet delivers the speed you need to surf, stream, and download. Plus, with Constant Guard by Xfinity, your family will get unmatched online security, and it's included at no additional cost. Call 1-800-880-7171 today and get speed, security, and savings from Xfinity for an amazing value. Ask how to upgrade to get in-home Wi-Fi from Xfinity that's four times faster than U-verse. Or get started with Xfinity Internet for $19.99 a month for 12 months. It's all backed by our 30-day money-back Comcast customer guarantee, so it's risk-free. Tomorrow could be awesome if you call today. Call 1-800-880-7171. That's 1-800-880-7171. Xfinity, the future of awesome.
She's my eye candy for obvious reasons. Nothing is smarter than a jumpsuit, especially when it's sexy. Go. Tell me about your outfit.
How you doing, Wendy?
How you doing?
I love a great jumpsuit. It has a great backless detail.
Uh-huh.
One leg. And my shoes were $30 from Steve Madden.
Love it. Tell your mom I said happy birthday, and we'll be right back. Thank you, Leah.
Introducing the first ever gummy multivitamin from Centrum. A complete and tasty new way to support your energy, immunity, and metabolism like never before. Centrum Multigummies. See gummies in a whole new light.
See this sandal?
Half off.
This pair?
Half off.
It's a red button. Every sandal, every store, up to 50% off.
Even found a pair under $10.
Sandals for everybody!
Everybody loves to pay less.
Standby, cameras and lights. Places, please.
Crime Stoppers behind the scenes as an officer continues to search to find out who killed a local two-year-old. Then, a day-by-day, hour-by-hour look at the weather in your neighborhood and what you need to know to plan your weekend. Today on WPTV News Channel 5 at 5.
Celebrate the summer with the best-reviewed comedy of the year.
Damn it! We'll put your roof on a scooter!
Spy
Why is a comic triumph?
Give me your coat.
This is a man's coat.
Yeah, but I don't see a man, do I? I see a reject from The Sound of Music.
Spy. Rated R. Tomorrow.
Texting and driving can get you killed. The attorneys of Cersei Denny, taking time to care.
It's the Loretta and Lou Show, sponsored by Capital Carpet and Tile.
Mom, what are you doing?
You know I talk to all our customers about their experience. This is Nancy and Dave.
There is so much to choose from, and we loved our salesperson.
We come back because your prices and installers are always great.
At Capital Carpet and Tile, Mom calls her after every sale. Customers love us. We even received the Angie's List Super Service Award. And we have the best prices.
So why would you buy from anyone else?
Aquarius is summer's most exciting new series.
You are unbelievable.
I can be a tad brusque.
Tonight, the hunt for one of America's most notorious criminals.
I'm Charlie Manson.
Has just begun.
Onward to glory, young buck.
New Aquarius, tonight, 9, 8 central, followed by Hannibal on NBC. Hannibal earned a perfect score on Rotten Tomatoes. And it beat every other show to win Hulu's Best of the Best. Isn't it time you discovered Hannibal? Premieres tonight after Aquarius, here on NBC.
Why is it that when your heart skips a beat is when you feel most alive? Schumacher presents the perfect car for the Palm Beaches starting under $23,000. The 2015 Chevy Camaro, only at Schumacher.
Every morning, this is local news everywhere. Mornings on WPTV News Channel 5.
Tomorrow's Friday, but I want to thank my guests today and my fabulous co-host, my stylish studio audience. I love you for watching today, and I'll see you next time on Wendy. Bye-bye.
The Now South Florida, stories everyone's talking about right now.
Making sure you're in the know.
With new information before everyone else.
It's a bold new way to get your news. The Now South Florida, weekdays at 4 on WPTV News Channel 5.
Some people go to Greece and bring back a statue. Me, I went to Greece and brought back a pizza.
The Greek pizza is back, a large for $12. And try our new garlic knots or our new cinnamon knots for just $5 more.
Better ingredients, better pizza. PapaJohns.com.
Get ready for even bigger deals at the Ashley Furniture Home Store Super Savings Event. Find incredible deals on our huge selection of furniture. Plus, no interest until January 2017. And delivery today, every day. Save big on these beautiful beds. Stay cozy on any of these stylish sofas. And gather around this classic dining room. Hurry in, sale ends this Monday. Now at Ashley Furniture Home Store. This is home.
This is Brian. Every day, Brian drives carefully to work. And every day Brian drives carefully to work, there are rate suckers. He's been paying more for car insurance because of their bad driving for so long, he doesn't even notice them anymore. But one day, Brian gets snapshotted from Progressive. Now Brian has a rate based on his driving, not theirs. Get snapshot and see just how much your good driving could save you.
Catch your News Channel 5 updates throughout the day on News Radio WJNO.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Shannon Cake. Welcome to the Now South Florida. We begin right now with breaking news. I-95 southbound at Donald Ross Road has been shut down. Palm Beach County Fire Rescue confirming a deadly accident in that area. We want to go straight to the Now's Michelle Casado live at the scene. Michelle.
Right now, all southbound lanes of I-95 near the Donald Ross Road exit are completely shut down. The Florida Highway Patrol is investigating a pedestrian death out here. What FHP tells me happened is that a car was traveling south and had, for some reason, pulled over to the right shoulder of the highway. A woman got out of the vehicle, a passenger in the vehicle got out and ran into oncoming traffic and was hit by an SUV. Right now, FHP is still investigating why the passenger got out of the car and what exactly led to this accident. right now, all 95 southbound lanes are shut down. There is one lane open for drivers getting on the ramp from Donald Ross Road exit. I'm told by FHP that they do expect to have all lanes open within the next hour. But right now, a very active scene out here. We're still waiting to find out more information. Once we have that, we'll bring it to you. For now, we are live from Palm Beach Gardens. Michelle Quesada for the Now.
Michelle, thank you. Now to some new developments at St. Mary's Medical Center this afternoon. A panel of doctors that reviewed the hospital's track record had suggested the hospital's staff isn't doing enough pediatric open heart surgeries to do them safely. Since CNN's first report aired, that is with the network that's carrying this investigation at the moment, since that original investigation aired, another baby has died. Elizabeth Cohen from CNN reports.
Davy Ricardo Brandao, born March 3rd, he died Tuesday. His mother posting on her Facebook page, Luto, Portuguese for mourning. Davy was born with a severe heart defect called truncus arteriosus, his mother says. Instead of having two main blood vessels coming out of his heart, Davy had only one. Nationally, 90% of babies survived the surgery to correct this defect. Davy's surgery in March didn't go as well as expected, his mother says, and so he had a second surgery later that month. In April, St. Mary's Medical Center told us the patient is recovering well and the prognosis is good. It's not known why Davy died. What we do know is this. Last year, an expert panel sent in by the state of Florida reviewed the St. Mary's program. The head of the team, Dr. Jeffrey Jacobs, advised St. Mary's to stop doing heart surgery on babies like Davy under 6 months old. But St. Mary's continued, saying that was just a recommendation, not a mandate. Davy's now the ninth baby to die after heart surgery at St. Mary's since the program started at the end of 2011. Amelia Campbell died in 2012 after heart surgery at St. Mary's. Her mother, Naka, heard the news about Davy today.
I feel horrible. I feel saddened. I feel disgusted.
She thinks St. Mary's is doing these lucrative surgeries for the money and wants them to stop.
How are you justifying this in your mind? I mean, what are you, find something else to do. You're not good at this.
Using data St. Mary's submitted to the state of Florida, CNN calculates that from 2011 through 2013, the program's mortality rate for pediatric open heart surgeries was 12.5%. That's more than three times higher than the national average. Safety experts say St. Mary's does too few pediatric heart surgeries, not getting enough practice to get good at them. The hospital's own data shows it undertook 27 pediatric open heart surgeries in 2012, 20 in 2013, and just 18 last year.
These volumes are quite low. Practice makes perfect, or at least makes it better.
St. Mary's disputes CNN's calculation of its high mortality rate, but refuses to provide what it considers the correct death rate. In a letter to employees Tuesday, Carboni said over the past year, our mortality rate has been consistent with national average and does not significantly exceed the mortality rate of other programs, as the CNN story alleges. But the hospital declined to provide CNN any evidence to support that claim. That leaves parents like these infuriated and grieving for their own babies and for the most recent baby, who never left St. Mary's Medical Center following his surgeries. Elizabeth Cohen, CNN, New York.
Coming up at 5 o'clock tonight, we will be digging deeper on this investigation. We're actually talking to a lawyer who has filed a lawsuit against the hospital on behalf of local parents. A last-minute change that even caught West Palm Beach city leaders by surprise. The school that we first told you about yesterday that planned to open near the 45th Street Flea Market is withdrawing the application with the city now. That happened, in fact, just a couple hours ago. The president of Florida Future Academy says once they got word the city's planning and zoning board would likely deny their application, they decided to look for a new location. School developers originally had plans to open in an abandoned office building just feet from the 45th Street Flea Market. It's an area city leaders call one of their most troublesome properties.
The students need an opportunity to get educated, but that was not the right place to put it.
School leaders say they've already found a new spot for the school, but they don't want to say where until the deal is finalized. The school year's over for the Palm Beach County school students out there, but police saying that that doesn't mean that drivers can hit the gas around schools now. Summer school right around the corner, and those reduced speed limits certainly do apply. The Now's Charlie Keegan live with more.
Right, I'm outside Citrus Cove Elementary School in Boynton Beach right now. You can see behind me the school speed limit is marked. It's 20 miles per hour, and you'll pay twice as much if you're caught speeding in one of these zones. Fines double in school zones. And believe it or not, many students will actually be in school during the summer. For example, pre-kindergarten classes start next week. So expect to see police officers out and about over the next few months. In Boynton Beach, they'll be keeping an eye on schools anytime children are around. Now, today I hung out with the police officers when they were out here checking radar, looking at speeds of drivers in the area. In about 40 minutes, they pulled over three people for speeding. Two of those people got a $306 ticket.
The state made these fines that expensive for a reason. The reason is because they want to keep kids safe. And, you know, sometimes it's you have to do something significant to get it through to people that this is what they need to be doing.
So not every school offers summer classes, but others, almost every school has some sort of camp going on. A lot of schools offer lunch and breakfast to students who normally wouldn't get it unless they were at school. So there will be a lot of activity around the schools during the summer. And the message from police is definitely drive cautiously anytime you're around a school. In Boynton Beach, Charlie Keegan for the Now South Florida.
Thank you. Now that school is out for the summer, drivers being reminded to watch out for kids out there playing along the roadways. Most importantly, slow down. Don't drive distracted. Be alert for children playing at any time of the day now. They may be darting out into the street without even looking. And the same goes certainly for backing out of your driveway. Watch for bikers and skateboarders passing behind you at odd times of the day now, middle of the day. We're used to kids being in school, right? For parents out there, dress your kids in bright colors so that drivers will be able to see them a lot more easily. And students, always wear a helmet if you're on a skateboard or a bicycle. Steve Weigel, just actually, if we can be transparent about this, he literally just walked into the studio because of that breaking news we told you about at the top of the newscast where the southbound 995 was shut down. So literally we were saying welcome to you and Steve came in the studio. So
everyone is taking a detour up around Indiantown Road. It is pretty crazy. If you can avoid that area, please do.
Absolutely.
Around 95 in Indiantown and around Donald Ross, because it is it's a mess. It took me an extra hour to get into work.
Wow. Yeah. Incredible. So in 5 seconds, were you able to pull together a quick forecast for us?
Yeah. Well, we've got some
He's that good.
I am that good, especially on a day like this. This is what we call crunch time here, and we do have some nice weather, so that makes it a little bit easier. There are some showers, though, on the radar this afternoon. They're inland and not at the coastline, so they're tracking toward the lake. Coastal showers still possible, but our best rain chances are from Belgrade into Okeechobee, and you can see a couple of stray showers. Actually, let me get a little bit closer here and show you West Boca, that area around Coral Springs and Sawgrass, a few showers. Also, back around Lion Country Safari, and there's a few on the eastern side of the lake. Not a lot of significant rainfall, but some popping up, and it was a nice day. Are we going to have more as we get into the weekend? We're going to talk about that coming up.
All right, Steve, thanks. Travelers, so hungry for airfare deals, crashing Southwest website. Remember, we told you yesterday you could get great deals at Southwest? Well, Molly Hendrickson is joining us live from the Now National Desk. And Molly, Southwest's sale also sparked a fare war among airlines out there. It's good news for travelers.
Yeah, anytime there's an airfare war, travelers end up the real winners. So when Southwest announced super low fares between August and December, others got on board. Airlines like American and United say they'll match those fares where they can. Southwest's three-day sale, though, particularly impressive, so impressive, the website actually crashed. In fact, it's still nearly impossible to get access. And not surprising when you discover the airline was offering one-way fares for just $49. But Southwest saying today it's extending the deal one more day. You have until Friday at midnight to snatch up those cheap tickets. Back to you.
I also saw there were some one-way tickets for as low as $49. That sounds too good to be true.
Yeah, it does sound too good to be true, but those fares do exist. Don't get your hopes too high, though. You aren't going to get that fare on a holiday, Friday or Sunday, but it's still a pretty good deal.
Molly, thanks. Coming up here on the Now, another politician throws his hat into the ring for the GOP nomination, but if he wants to win, he better get a grip and hip to social media, how it is actually changing the game in the upcoming presidential election. Plus, a new gadget to keep you hydrated, how it helps you get exactly the amount of water you need every single day to stay healthy.
When it's 5 o'clock on News Channel 5, you need to know what's happening right now.
Local coverage everywhere.
The only local reporter in Baltimore.
Steve Winkle with weather, safety, and accuracy right when and where you need it.
Off Boynton Beach in Delray.
The only local chopper getting you breaking news first.
Broke into several cars and then fired.
Now that's local coverage you can count on. WPTV News Channel 5.
At Bedner's, freshness sounds like this. And looks like this. I'm Steve Bedner. Visit Bedner's today. Fresh, locally grown produce from our farm to your table.
It is very difficult to get into a cardiovascular ICU. I think this is a testament to the quality of education provided by Kaiser University to even be considered for this position as a recent graduate. The hands-on learning definitely has helped me in my real-world practice. My name is Daniel Hargrove. I'm currently a registered nurse at one of the largest hospitals in Florida. I was able to get into this position because of Kaiser University.
When you have a hole in your neck, don't face the shower head. Keep your stomach covered when you're outside. Be very careful shaving. Get used to eating only soft foods. Clean out your speech valve twice a day.
Find three ways to quit at tobaccofreeflorida.com. Call, click, or come in.
Someone's got sweet tea. Every day is Sunday in my bag. Even if it's a Tuesday, it's still Sweet Sunday.
Get Rallies and Checkers' new Sunday Stackers. Strawberry cheesecake or Oreo raspberry, just $1.99 each. Rallies and Checkers.
Send the bag.
Why am I so awake?
Did you know your brain has a wake system and a sleep system? Science suggests when you have insomnia, the neurotransmitters in your wake system may be too strong, which may be preventing you from getting the sleep you need. Talk to your doctor about ways to manage your insomnia.
Enjoy your new shield.
Thanks. How much did you spend on this?
Nothing. It was free, and they put it in just a day.
Well, if it was free and they put it in that fast, how good could it be?
You tell me.
She's got a Sloman Shield, the ultimate home security system. It's free, and yes, it's real good.
Okay, the system's great, honey. Please disarm it.
At Bedner's, freshness sounds like this. And looks like this. I'm Steve Bedner. Visit Bedner's today. Fresh, locally grown produce from our farm to your table.
Today, we have learned former Florida Governor Jeb Bush is expected to enter the presidential race June 15th in Miami. Bush tweeted this morning that he will make the formal announcement at Miami-Dade College Kendall's campus. The 62-year-old's announcement will follow a week-long trip to Europe that begins Monday. If he runs, Bush will join an already packed field of GOP presidential candidates. That includes Senator Marco Rubio, Senator Ted Cruz, former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee, and Senator Rand Paul, just to name a few. The list of Republican presidential candidates for 2016 does continue to grow. Molly Hendrickson has been keeping an eye on the presidential bids from the now national desk. And today, Rick Perry announcing he is making his second run for the White House.
The Republican field getting pretty crowded, and we're still a year and a half from Election Day. But let's add another to the list.
The reason I'm running for president is I know for certain our country's best days lie ahead. There is nothing wrong in America today that a change of leadership will not make happen.
Former Texas Governor Rick Perry joins nine other Republican candidates who have officially announced their bids. They are Marco Rubio, Rand Paul, Ted Cruz, Ben Carson, Carly Fiorina, Mike Huckabee, Lindsey Graham, George Pataki, and Rick Santorum. But this is just the beginning. At least another handful are expected to throw their hat in the ring. This will be Perry's second run for the White House. Back to you.
Molly, thanks. That field certainly is growing. Politicians better get hip to Facebook if they aren't already. New research is showing that is where the majority of people are getting their news, and it's not just young people. The Now's Holly Davis is breaking down this new poll.
Millennials still lead the pack and get their news, 61% that is, from Facebook at least once a week. You can see, in fact, the breakdown right here. Millennials using Facebook. They also like CNN. Baby boomers, though, those are your 50 to 68-year-olds. They're catching on to Facebook as well, 39%, so not that high. A lot still prefer local TV. And then Generation X, talking about them, too. They love Facebook, 51%. These are your folks who are in between your millennials and your baby boomers, but they also largely depend on local TV for political news. This is a Pew Research study done recently within the last month. So it really is going to be interesting to see how the ebbs and flows that take place from now until, say, for instance, the presidential race. Shannon.
Holliny. Thanks. Outrage and humiliation. That is what hundreds of Disney employees felt when the company fired them, then asked them to train their replacements. We're talking Disney here, okay? And we talk enough good things about Disney on the show. We wanted to tell you about this. About 250 workers who kept Disney's data systems running for the company say that their jobs were then transferred to immigrants on temporary visas brought in by an outsourcing firm based in India. The fired employees were then required to train the people taking over their jobs. Layoffs like these raising a lot of questions about how companies are using temporary visas and whether they complement American workers or they are actually displacing them. Bad press and rising ticket prices. It's not keeping visitors away from Florida theme parks, though. The bad press we just mentioned. The Now's Jay Cashmere joining me with the new numbers on attendance just released.
People love Mickey Mouse.
Right.
And they certainly do because they show it when their wallet, when it comes out, especially now over the summertime. They're not letting money come between them or Mickey Mouse or Harry Potter. Attendance up at all but two of Florida parks last year. The Themed Entertainment Association just released its attendance report for 2014. And get this, Shannon, Disney's Magic Kingdom topping the list, not just in North America, but the entire world, 19 million visitors. That's up 4% from the previous year. Its sister parks, Epcot, Animal Kingdom, and Hollywood Studios all showed 2% increases. Universal Studios didn't welcome the most visitors, but it did see the most growth, 17% over the previous year. That's 8 million Harry Potter-loving guests. Busch Gardens in Tampa also saw a 1% spike with 4 million visitors. The two parks with no growth, Universal's Islands of Adventure, stayed flat at about 8 million. And no surprise here, SeaWorld took a huge hit. Attendance down 8% to just 4.5 million guests. Of course, we all know why. SeaWorld's attendance and revenue has been critically hurt since that documentary Blackfish came out in 2013. They're still feeling the effects of that as well.
But Magic Kingdom still right there at the top.
We love Mickey Mouse, don't we?
Jay Cashmere, thank you.
You bet.
We'll see you at 5:30.
You bet.
For the first time ever, Barbie is able to kick off her heels and opt for a pair of comfy flats. Toy company Mattel launching a new version of the iconic doll that features adjustable ankles, allowing Barbie to wear heels or flats. We should do this with a real pair of shoes. That's brilliant. The new version of the doll will be part of the company's Fashionista range that also sees Barbie being made available with 8 different skin tones, 23 hair colors, 22 different hairstyles, and 14 facial sculpts, and 18 eye colors, too. Other Barbie Fashionista dolls feature Barbie with feet in the perma-flat position. We all know how important it is to stay hydrated, especially this time of year, right? It's important to your health. But knowing and doing, those are two different things. Now, this high-tech water bottle can help make sure that you're drinking enough water every single day. The Hydrate Me is connected to your smartphone, and it glows when you need to take a sip. It has a sensor that monitors your water intake, and it syncs that information up with an app on your smartphone. If it's time to take a sip, the bottle just starts glowing. It's expected to be available this winter at a cost of $39 a piece. Pretty bright idea. Heading back to Chief Meteorologist Steve Whelan. You've had a little more time,
yeah.
Although that last forecast was brilliant.
I was thinking that was a pretty good idea, having that, Damana.
Yeah, I need my reminder.
Especially here in the summer, it's so hot and humid, we lose so much fluids that sometimes you realize it until
That's
it's
right.
too late.
That's right.
Well, we do have some water coming down in the form of rainfall, Shannon, and we also have bigger rains right on our doorstep. Look at all this stuff that's over Cuba and all the way back into the Bahamas. And this weather in the short term does not have an impact on us. It stays to the south and stays to the east. But in the long term, as we get out day four, day five, it does eventually come back at us and brings us some rain. But we do have a few showers. This is all part of that sea breeze that's kicked in. Most of it is over alligators at this point. Nothing really too tremendous out there. There's a pretty good rain cell over Port Mayaca on the eastern side of the lake, and current temperatures are a mix of low and mid 80s. We are looking at pretty much a carbon copy on Friday, and we're keeping a close eye on the weekend, putting the computer models together, and I'll have more on that coming up.
All right. We'll see you then, Steve. Thanks. The family at the center of that sexual abuse scandal finally breaking their silence, raising really more questions, though, about the relationships between their son and his sisters. What the Duggar parents said in their first television interview coming up. Also, is Vera Bradley so 2000 late? Why the popular designer's sales are suffering right now, it's coming up next on The Now. And WPTV News Channel 5, Treasure Coast Newspapers, and TCPalm.com, the largest news partnership on the Treasure Coast.
Do you decorate a room? Check out Rooms to Go. It's that easy, because we have room after beautiful room, all perfectly matched at a low package price, available for delivery as soon as tomorrow. Rooms to Go, where decorating is a snap.
The School District of Palm Beach County. More choice programs and career academies. More graduates. More STEM. More arts. More sports. More of everything. Palm Beach County Schools, PBC Public Proud.
You dreamt of a condo next to the train. Then I showed you how it shook as it came. And you saw close to and next to are not quite the same. Let a RE/MAX agent guide you. RE/MAX, dream with your eyes open.
Get the complete balanced nutrition of Ensure with 9 grams of protein and 26 vitamins and minerals.
And now, with twice as much vitamin D, which up to 90% of people don't get enough of.
Oh, the sunshine vitamin.
Ensure. Take life in.
I don't believe you.
No way.
How's that possible?
That's crazy.
I don't believe you.
I find that really hard to believe.
I don't know about that.
No way.
Two pairs of glasses for $69.95 with a free eye exam.
I paid way too much.
It's true. At America's Best, we've been selling quality eyewear at low prices for 35 years. Call 1-800-2-PAIR or visit americasbest.com today.
Just steps away from the water, relax, and enjoy the atmosphere and amazing food at Mulligan's Beach House Bar and Grill.
Try Mulligan's Asian Dragon Salad with Firecracker Shrimp, Bluesy's Black and Blue Burger, Fish and Chips, or Steak Gorgonzola Flatbread.
Open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. A family meal at Mulligan's is fun and affordable. All day, every day. Mulligan's, 12 weeks of summer, where kids eat free Monday through Friday, 3 to 9 p.m.
We had such a great experience with Empire, we would recommend it to anyone.
Real customers share their stories about Empire today.
As a matter of fact, we already have. The customer service and the personal touch was really where it's at. The quality, too, is important to us, and the quality of the flooring was great. I mean, we've had people come in our home and say, wow, this is really beautiful. Where'd you have it done? Empire.
800-588-2300, Empire.
Today.
Doesn't this look great?
So great.
It's beautiful.
So beautiful, Cindy.
And the attention to detail?
The attention to detail. So solid.
Now, two great collections at one great store.
Rooms to Go.
Back here on the Now South Florida, a wildlife biologist was out hunting some turkeys, and he found out he was actually the prey. Our friends at Right This Minute have more.
What's up, the Now? Pettigrew.
And I'm Gail Bass, and Kevin Walter has quite the story to share. He was turkey hunting, but he's also a wildlife biologist. And notice what's creeping up on him. That would be a bobcat.
It looks like he's being hunted right now.
Well, not exactly him. He says once he turned on his camera and started filming that bobcat, he thinks the bobcat was after the camera, not him. And watch what he does next.
Whoa, just right in his
his face. Is he okay?
He is okay. He said no harm, no foul.
For more great videos just like this, tune in to Right This Minute.
Thanks, guys. Catch the full episode of Right This Minute at 7:30, right after the list today. We have some news coming in here, and 5 o'clock anchor Michael Williams, News Channel 5, 5 o'clock anchor Michael Williams.
Michael
is here
will suffice. you and I have known each other longer.
I know. No need for
hopefully
the
formalities. Hopefully most of you know me by now. At any rate, I'm fortunate to come into your living rooms and always humbled by that as you
absolutely
are. We got a neat story for you tonight. A lot of construction, if you come down to West Palm Beach a lot, see a lot of the high rises going
right
up. But one of the things we're looking at is some of the older properties are now becoming the hottest properties here. We're going to take a look at that. It's
that's
an interesting
fun
twist on the ongoing development we see in every community. So we're going to take a peek at that for you. As we know, many of you come down to the downtown core here and there.
Yes. Everything old is new again at some point, right,
really
Michael?
Really
looking
is
forward to that. It's a nice uplifting story. Appreciate
yep
it. We'll see you then. It has been labeled the female Viagra. We've been following this for you. It could soon be legal. The pros and cons for women if this does in fact happen. And two Florida realtors. Remember this story? Incredible, wasn't it? Held at gunpoint by a potential buyer, what their counterparts are learning from their frightening ordeal, and what they're changing to protect themselves.
Why do dads love Carvel? Simply, it's delicious. Give dad a fresh-made Fudgy the Whale Cake for Father's Day. America's freshest ice cream, only at Carvel.
Yo! No thank you for the bag, man. I hooked you up, bro. Try getting a deal like that from some other bag. Bet you feel rich now. Hey, ladies, this dude's loaded.
Checkers and Rally's 2-for-2 deal is back. Your favorite crispy fish with Alaskan filet or our boldly seasoned spicy chicken sandwich. Mix or match them for just $2.
Hey, man, how about a fry for the lady?
Checkers and Rally's.
Send the bag.
Sleek international style with the welcome embrace of home. City Furniture presents Encore. Simple, clean shapes designed to adapt seamlessly to any environment. Just like you. Encore. Available today at City Furniture.
I'm so relieved my mom decided to get some help from Whitsum's Nursing. She tried other companies, but they didn't work out. Whitsum's has a great reputation for matching the best caregivers with their patients. Now, Mom's happy, and I have peace of mind knowing she's getting the care she needs.
Whitsum's Nursing Service has been providing quality home health care by matching the best caregivers with our patients since 1996. Call Whitsum's for all your nursing and home health care needs, or log on to Whitsum's.com.
Enjoy your new shield.
Thanks. How much did you spend on this?
Nothing. It was free, and they put it in just a day.
Well, if it was free and they put it in that fast, how good could it be?
You tell me.
She's got a Sloman Shield, the ultimate home security system. It's free, and yes, it's real good.
Okay, the system's great, honey. Please disarm it. Hi, it's the Mo and Sally Morning Show from Cool 105.5. Get WPTV News Channel 5 weather updates from Steve Weigel and Storm Team 5 every hour during your workday.
News Channel 5 and Cool 105.5, keeping you safe and secure.
How do we make Carvel Sundays even more delicious? We make one free. Every Wednesday, buy one classic sundae, get another free. America's freshest ice cream, only at Carvel.
We want to go back to that breaking news we told you about at the top of this newscast. I-95 southbound at Donald Ross Road had been shut down after a deadly accident in that area. Let's go straight to the Now's Michelle Quesada. She's live there near the scene with an update on the situation. Michelle?
FHP cleared the scene here just a few minutes ago. Traffic is moving again on I-95 South here in Palm Beach Gardens. Now, FHP tells us what happened was a man and a woman traveling south of the Donald Ross Road exit were having some type of a domestic situation. The driver pulled over on the left shoulder of the highway. FHP says the woman got out of the car and ran onto oncoming traffic and was hit and killed.
Something was going on, some type of argument or disagreement. Driver pulled over to try to calm down the passenger. Once he got stopped, passenger exited, ran into traffic, and was hit by the black Navigator that you see there.
With FHP tells us that SUV you're looking at right now, the driver of that SUV tried to avoid hitting the woman but couldn't. Right now, the identification of that victim has not been released. We are live in Palm Beach Gardens. Michelle Quesada for The Now.
Michelle, thank you. A warning right now for parents from Florida Department of Law Enforcement. Pasco County deputies and narcotics detectives say they're seeing marijuana concentrates in the Tampa Bay area right now. It's created by extracting the THC from the plant using butane heat. This is extremely potent. It can be laced actually into another substance like candy. People have also been seriously injured in explosions while trying to make this stuff. The sheriff's office in that area says that marijuana legalization in other parts of the country is behind the popularity of the concentrates here in Florida. Wiping out mosquitoes, wouldn't that be nice? We can't get rid of them altogether, but on the Treasure Coast, they're doing what they can to keep the numbers down. Martin County residents urged right now to drain and cover to prevent mosquito breeding and biting. That's drain your standing water to stop mosquitoes from multiplying. You should cover your skin with clothing or repellent and cover doors and windows as well with screens to keep mosquitoes out of your house. Can't figure out where to go for your summer vacation? You're running out of time here. How about Alcatraz in San Francisco? The landmark has locked up the title of America's favorite landmark. This is in TripAdvisor's annual Traveler's Choice Awards. The Golden Gate Bridge, also in San Francisco, landed in second place, so that's perfect. While the Lincoln Memorial in Washington, D.C., and the reflecting pool there, they tied for third. TripAdvisor identified the top landmarks based on traveler reviews and opinions that were gathered over a 12-month time period. Visitors can once again visit the inside of the Washington Monument. There it is, with a little haze over top. The National Park Service there says repairs are finally finished and visitors are welcome once again. The monument closed on Monday because of a power failure. 63 people were at the top when the elevator failed. The Washington Monument, nobody was hurt though. The Washington Monument is the most prominent site in Washington, D.C. It was built in honor of President George Washington. It is a move unlike any other, a massive home being moved from Seattle to Bainbridge Island via ferry here. Crews attaching the 6,500-square-foot house to a barge where it will then float across the Puget Sound to the new resting spot for it. Workers spent 2.5 months preparing for the mansion to move and creating tunnels under concrete and putting 3 layers of crisscross steel and more than a dozen dollies under the home to lift it onto that barge. Amazing sight, isn't it? The house was built in 1923 and it needed to be torn down. Instead, a new owner purchased it and decided to move it for a minimum of $750,000. It should be move-in ready by August. A female Viagra, meant to boost the woman's libido, has a meeting with the Food and Drug Administration. Molly Hendrickson joins us from the Now National Desk with how this new drug could change women's lives if approved.
Some people call it pink Viagra, and if the FDA gives approval, premenopausal women tired of a low sex drive may have the answer in the form of a pill. HSDD, or hypoactive sexual desire disorder, is known to seriously affect the quality of some women's lives. The drug is officially called flibanserin. If approved, it would be the first ever non-hormonal treatment for HSDD to hit the open market. Makers say women in clinical trials around the age of 36 who took the drug for 5 months reported having an increased sexual desire. Now, the drug has some women's groups worried. At least one group has warned the FDA it can cause low blood pressure and is bad for your health when taken without alcohol. Back to you.
Molly, thanks. Add Subway to the growing list of restaurants eliminating artificial ingredients from its foods. The sandwich chain, known for its $5 footlong, says it will be dropping artificial flavors, colors, and preservatives from its menu. The move comes as Subway continues to market its food as a fresher, healthier alternative to other fast food chains. The purge of artificial ingredients is quickly becoming the norm in other restaurants, including Chipotle, Panera Bread, and Pizza Hut recently announcing similar moves. Subway says it plans to have all artificial ingredients out of its food by the year 2017. The new season of Hannibal starts tonight with a change of scenery. We'll have a preview coming up on the Now.
My family and I are having dinner at our favorite restaurant. Can you tell who at this table is hearing better with all this noise? If you assumed it was one of them, you'd be mistaken. Thanks to the revolutionary technology of Ultra Hearing Aids, exclusively from Hear USA, I hear better than others with normal hearing in noisy places, like this restaurant. Two clinical studies have proven that Ultra Hearing Aids outperform normal hearing in certain demanding listening situations.
Watch, Dad'll probably get two desserts.
I heard that.
Of course you did.
Ultra Hearing Aids are so advanced, you can even adjust your settings using your smartphone. The future of hearing technology is here, and it's more powerful than anyone could have imagined. There's nothing else like it. Try them out for yourself. Call Hear USA now to schedule your free hearing checkup, and you'll also receive a free $25 gift card. Don't wait. Start hearing what you want to hear today.
Why is it that when your heart skips a beat is when you feel most alive? Chevy Camaro from Schumacher. Perfect car for the Palm Beaches. Cool, head-turning, from the standard V6 to the amped-up V8. And the price? Under $23,000. Under $23,000 for the power and style of Chevy Camaro from Schumacher.
For the best Chevy experience in the Palm Beaches, come join the family at Schumacher.
Make tomorrow awesome with Xfinity Internet from Comcast. Call 1-800-880-7171 today. And do what you love online with Xfinity Internet for only $19.99 a month for 12 months. Xfinity Internet delivers the speed you need to surf, stream, and download. Plus, with Constant Guard by Xfinity, your family will get unmatched online security. And it's included at no additional cost. Call 1-800-880-7171 today and get speed, security, and savings from Xfinity for an amazing value. Ask how to upgrade to get in-home Wi-Fi from Xfinity that's four times faster than UVerse. Or get started with Xfinity Internet for $19.99 a month for 12 months. It's all backed by our 30-day money-back Comcast customer guarantee, so it's risk-free. Tomorrow could be awesome if you call today. Call 1-800-880-7171. That's 1-800-880-7171. Xfinity, the future of awesome.
Enjoy your new shield.
Thanks. How much did you spend on this?
Nothing. It was free, and they put it in just a day.
Well, if it was free and they put it in that fast, how good could it be?
You tell me.
She's got a Sloman Shield, the ultimate home security system. It's free, and yes, it's real good.
Okay, the system's great, honey. Please disarm it.
NBC serial killer drama Hannibal returns for a new season tonight, and after the bloody events of last year's season finale, wow, changes apparently are in store. Mark Barger has a preview.
Hannibal has a change of scenery for season 3. The serial killers fled the U.S., but left behind a trail of clues for profiler Will Graham to follow.
He left us his broken heart.
The fact that Will rendered Hannibal vulnerable, but then also tricked him for a while, I think was profoundly upsetting to Hannibal.
That pushes the killer to set up his morbid shop in Florence, Italy.
Hannibal is kind of in the element that he loves. He's in cities full of history and cities full of art.
I've killed hardly anybody during our residence.
And he's got his psychiatrist, Bedelia de Maurier, along with him.
There's a lot of cat and mouse stuff that's going on between her and Hannibal in Florence.
Gillian Anderson's character poses as Hannibal's wife, but raises her own mysteries.
She is ambiguous, and her motivations are ambiguous, but also her future is ambiguous.
Always a concern when you're hanging out with a madman.
Say you're observing, but this is participation, Bedelia.
She could be as dark as Hannibal.
She has a curiosity for the dark side of the world that she cannot run away from.
And that fans of Hannibal can't resist.
If you are free, my wife and I would love to have you for dinner.
Mark Barger, NBC News.
Hannibal premieres tonight at 10 o'clock right here on News Channel 5 following a new episode of Aquarius starring David Duchovny. Straight ahead here on The Now.
The stars of 19 Kids and Counting breaking their silence, speaking for the first time about their son's molestation scandal. I'm Molly Hendrickson with The Now's National Desk. Coming up, I'll show you how the internet is reacting and why the interview may have backfired.
Also, a true local inspiration. This man is kicking cancer in the teeth, he says, and the little girl who keeps him going. Stay with us.
When it's 5 o'clock on News Channel 5, you need to know what's happening right now. Local coverage everywhere.
The only local reporter in Baltimore.
Steve Winkle with weather safety and accuracy right when and where you need it.
Off Boynton Beach in Delray.
The only local chopper getting you breaking news first.
Broke into several cars and then fired.
Now that's local coverage you can count on. WPTV News Channel 5.
We're donating!
And you can help, too. Come to the Operation Sneaks kickoff event at Festival Flea Market Mall on June 6th. Donate shoes or backpacks during Operation Sneaks and receive 20 FestiValue dollars. Operation Sneaks benefits in Jacob's Shoes.
Get the complete balanced nutrition of Ensure with 9 grams of protein and 26 vitamins and minerals.
And now, with twice as much vitamin D, which up to 90% of people don't get enough of.
Oh, the sunshine vitamin.
Ensure. Take life in.
You're driving along, and then it happens. You get hurt in a car accident.
Call Rubenstein Law. A client of theirs hurt their neck, and Rubenstein Law got them $200,000. Now that's a lot of money.
I'm attorney Robert Rubenstein. Call me. I want to be your attorney.
At City Mattress, we make mattress buying easy. Our sleep consultants will help you select from over 80 mattress comforts at prices 10 to 20% below our competitors. We'll deliver it for free. And should you need, our comfort guarantee assures that you'll sleep comfortably for many nights. 5 decades of leadership has taught us that if we offer the best mattresses at the best prices and treat customers with respect and decency, they'll keep coming back. City Mattress, night after night, we're there for you.
Now through Tuesday, don't miss the ultimate sofa sale at Rooms To Go. And understand it really is the ultimate chance to save. Because every Rooms To Go sofa without exception is on sale. Get incredible savings on plush leather sofas, reclining sofas, sleeper sofas, sectionals, and fabric sofas. Any sofa you see has been reduced to a shocking low price. Remember, opportunities like this don't happen every day. So shop the ultimate sofa sale at Rooms To Go now through Tuesday. Every sofa is on sale.
Progressive Insurance here, and I'm a fox who thrives on the unexpected.
Ha ha! Shall we dine?
You wouldn't expect an insurance company to show you their rates and their competitors' rates, but that's precisely what we do. Going up? Nope. Coming down. And if you switch to Progressive today, you could save an average of over $500. Stop it. So call me today at the number below. Or is it above? Dismount! Oh, and he sticks the landing!
We're donating!
And you can help, too. Come to the Operation Sneaks kickoff event at Festival Flea Market Mall on June 6th. Donate shoes or backpacks during Operation Sneaks and receive 20 FestiValue dollars. Operation Sneaks benefits in Jacob's Shoes.
Now a look at what's making national and international news this afternoon. Our Ashley Hinson standing by in the feed room with what's coming in on the satellites. Ashley?
Well, Shannon, today Vice President Joe Biden and his family are welcoming visitors to Delaware's Legislative Hall to pay their respects to former Attorney General Beau Biden. The Vice President's eldest son died of brain cancer Saturday at the age of 46. He'll be laid to rest on Saturday. Meanwhile, Republican presidential candidate Ted Cruz is apologizing for carjacking a joke about the vice president as he mourns the death of his son. During an appearance, Cruz made a joke telling his audience he only needs to mention Biden's name to get a laugh. He apologized via Facebook, calling the joke a mistake. Rick Perry adding his name to the list of GOP presidential candidates, making it his second run for the White House. Perry has already spent more time than any other Republican candidate in Iowa, the state that kicks off presidential nomination voting. More bodies have been found in the wreckage of a Chinese cruise ship that capsized in bad weather, bringing the death toll now to 75. But they fear another 360 bodies are inside. So far, only 14 people survived. No word yet on what caused that ship to capsize. And those are your headlines in about 90 seconds, Shannon.
Ashley, thanks. The stars of 19 Kids and Counting blasted online, accused of minimizing their family's sex abuse scandal during last night's interview with Fox's Megyn Kelly. The Now's Molly Hendrickson has more on the fallout.
The Duggars broke their silence, hoping to clear things up after learning their eldest son, Josh, molested five young girls. Instead, it raised more questions, like why they waited more than a year to report the abuse to police, even though it continued at home.
One day after breaking their silence about their family's sex abuse scandal, and the Duggars are under fire. The Washington Post saying they cast themselves as martyrs, accusing them of downplaying the sexual abuse between their eldest son, Josh, and several young girls, including some of his sisters. The Duggars say at 14, Josh came to them, admitting to touching his victims.
I was struck by how much that they emphasized that it wasn't that big of a deal.
Dr. Marisol Urlacher is a psychotherapist really who works with victims of sexual abuse. She was alarmed the Duggars never got their son professional help, instead dealing with it in-house before sending him to a Christian-based training center in Arkansas.
They received the message that it's not that big of a deal. And I think that it can impact the way that people speak about it. It can impact the way that people actually come out and tell their story.
The U.S. Department of Justice reports juveniles account for more than one-third of sex offenders known to police. Most begin abusing between the ages of 12 and 14, targeting younger victims. The good news, with clinical help, about 85% don't commit future sex crimes.
You know, I think that the research is showing that if there's an early intervention, that you can have more positive results.
The Duggars maintain their son is not a pedophile, saying he was just a kid. Online, people are slamming the stars of 19 Kids and Counting for not taking action. Mario Lopez writes, molesting a child isn't a mistake, it's a crime. To call it anything else is minimizing and unfair to victims. And another Twitter user, Josh Duggar may have been a minor when he did awful, awful things, but his parents weren't minors when they covered it up.
And I think what's really important is that people actually start to open up a dialogue about what's important in families in terms of talking about healthy sexuality, allowing children the opportunity to speak about things that are difficult, and also giving children, empowering them to be able to make decisions about themselves and their bodies.
Two of the Duggar sisters who were apparent victims of the abuse are defending their brother. They say what he did was wrong, but he's not a child molester. Their interview with Megyn Kelly airs tomorrow on Fox. No word from TLC on the future of the show. From the Now National Desk, I'm Molly Hendrickson.
Molly, thanks. I'm here in the Weather Center now with Steve Weigel. We're looking toward the 5 o'clock news now.
Man, we're looking pretty good tonight. Fantastic weather if you're headed outside. Just a few clouds, some showers to the west, and overall a very pleasant evening for all of South Florida. The wider view shows big rains moving through the Bahamas, Cuba, back through Jamaica. Look at all that stuff. In the short term, it doesn't have an impact on our weather, but in the long term, it does, because it does bring us showers and storms. It's going to take a little while to get here, though. Looking pretty good on the radar. You can see the heaviest rain popping up just around western Boca and also a little bit around Port Mayaca. Your full forecast coming up at 5, Shannon.
We'll see you then, Steve. Thanks. I'm back in the newsroom once again, and Michael Williams looking toward the 5 as well.
I tell you, we've got an interesting story coming up in the next hour and a half. Artificial reefs, a lot of us have gone out over the years and done a lot of diving off South Florida, all the way up and down the coastline. James Whelan's going to take a look at a new reef that's going to be going in with a very different kind of creative touch. So you're going to enjoy this one. It's a neat story about trying to build up artificial reefs, but this one's got a little something special.
It sounds like you have great stories tonight at 5.
Got some neat stuff.
It's always exciting.
I think this one actually will be at the 5:30, but it's spread out over the hour and a half.
Perfect.
And as always, we hope you'll join us.
Thanks, Mike. We'll see you then.
Sure.
A top fashion house finds its magazine ad banned in the UK, some calling it irresponsible. But as Newsy's Catherine Beek shows us, it's much more difficult.
This Yves Saint Laurent fashion advertisement has been banned in the UK after it appeared in LUK magazine and a reader complaint. That order comes from the Advertising Standards Authority, which determined the ad was irresponsible because the model featured was unhealthily underweight. Various groups who help those with eating disorders have since applauded the decision, like Beat, a UK charity. A rep from the organization told CNN, "The ASA ruling is not about whether this person in the picture is healthy, but whether the images of her are being used in a way that can have an irresponsible effect on others. And we are really pleased to see that they are taking action to uphold their responsibility for the social impact of adverts." This decision to ban the ad came down just as the Royal College of Psychiatrists told the BBC the number of UK teenagers admitted to hospitals with eating disorders increased in recent years, largely because of social pressure made worse by online images. Now, we need to point out that the ad is only banned in the UK. An Ad Age employee told CBS it's much easier to get ads banned in the UK than, say, the United States.
In the UK, one consumer can make a complaint and get that ad banned almost immediately. Here in the US, it tends to be businesses that make complaints about competitors, and it takes a longer period of time.
YSL is no stranger to having its ads and models criticized either. In 2011, the Advertising Standards Authority banned the designer's commercial for its Beldopium perfume, pointing to a specific part where the model draws her finger up her arm. Some interpreted that as simulating drug use. And a blogger in Los Angeles created a change.org petition over a year ago to push YSL to stop using images of painfully thin models. The petition closed before it reached its necessary 50,000 supporters. Neither the designer nor LUK have commented on the Advertising Standards Authority's decision to ban the advertisement. For Newsy, I'm Katherine Beek. Watch Newsy 24/7 on your TV or download the Newsy app for on-the-go updates.
Thanks, Katherine. A lot of us own something Vera Bradley, a purse, a lunchbox, a phone holder. But are customers moving away from the brand now? The retailer, known for its colorful paisley pattern totes, is finding itself out of style, apparently, with consumers and investors these days. The designer has been shown the door by the fashionistas of Wall Street, apparently. Shares of the purse designer tanked yesterday. The problem, according to Vera Bradley, is that while it's continuing to offer these types of bags, it's just not resonating, or they resonate with existing customers, but they're not bringing in, these patterns aren't luring in any new customers. We'll see how they may regroup, reorganize, get some new designers in. We'll see what they do. I can't imagine Vera going away. Can you? In college, most of us were still trying to decide on a major, but a Brigham Young University student was doing much more than that when he was in school, and he scored big in the business world. Listen to this. Garrett Gee and a team of six others created Scan. That was the name of his business. It's a faster, more user-friendly barcode scanner. It got the attention of those producers from that show Shark Tank, but the investors during the show didn't bite. Then, as life sometimes goes, what you think is just a failure sometimes pays the way for something even better.
It turned out a lot of people watch TV, and our app had crazy downloads, crazy traffic. Angry Birds was like the number 10 spot, and then we ousted them.
Good for you. Knocking Angry Birds out of the running caught the attention of mobile app company Snapchat, which then bought Gee's company and barcode scanning app for $54 million. Can you imagine? The student turned millionaire still. Can't believe he's not dreaming. He still, by the way, lives in that two-bedroom apartment right there you saw a minute ago with his wife and his two kids. Humble, right? Keep it simple. The Florida man facing criminal charges, serious tone here, after staging a bizarre attack on a sheriff's deputy's patrol car. Did you hear about this? It was right outside of a Cape Coral house. You're not going to believe it. Take a look at this. Okay, there's a deputy inside there, by the way. In this video, you see the 45-year-old jumping onto the roof of the officer's SUV, and he just starts dancing. Then he jumps on the hood, apparently rips off the windshield wipers. Then he starts yelling toward the residents while wielding the wipers in the air. When responding officers finally arrived, he told them that he went into that home because when he opened the front door, a woman with fangs was threatening him and that a human sacrifice was about to occur involving vampires. Apparently, he was not on drugs. Interesting story. You see what our officers sometimes face out there. Police still looking for a suspect right now, wanted for holding two realtors at gunpoint in two separate incidents in St. Petersburg. We told you about the story yesterday. It was pretty frightening. The women both showing a home to this man when he pulled a gun and then tied one of their hands and feet with zip ties. Really frightening situation. The now Tampa Bay's Christy Post here with how realtors are protecting themselves. He has a goatee
and at the time of the incidents had a straw hat, long sleeve blue shirt.
Diane Shaddix is reading the alert she got a few hours after two women were robbed while showing homes in St. Petersburg.
It's unfortunate that people take advantage of us.
In 10 years, Shaddix has not had an incident as a realtor, crediting that to following these steps.
I always try to let someone know where I'm going, where I'll be, what time I'm going to be there, how many homes I'm showing, who the person is.
She also arms herself with an app.
You can set up automatically that you're going to do a showing.
Agents Armor allowing realtors to check in as you're showing a property as often as 15 minutes or 2 hours. In the event someone fails to check in, the application will send your GPS coordinates to certain contacts, law enforcement, or your brokerage.
Just be safe and be smart.
Shaddix saying it's just another level of protection that could save lives.
Keep that in the back of our minds because we are out there alone. And you never know when it's going to happen to you.
For the now, I'm Christy Post.
Terrifying. This year, more than 135,000 people will be diagnosed with melanoma, the most dangerous form of skin cancer. This according to the Skin Cancer Foundation. Years after this man's diagnosis with the disease, this Palm Beach County teacher continued to fight it while getting ready to run more than 1,000 miles for charity. The Now's Katie Johnson has this incredible story. Katie.
Hey, Shannon. Well, Brian Thomas teaches science and coaches track at Okeehele Middle School. And while many teachers may be relaxing for a few months now that school's out, he has other plans. He starts a 40-day journey this Saturday, running all the way to Washington, D.C. to help support fellow cancer fighters like himself.
At 36 years old, Brian Thomas is in great shape. He has to be, considering what he's about to do.
If it makes you happy, do it. And it does. This is what I want to do with my life.
What he's doing is running more than 1,000 miles, a distance that may not be as challenging to him as the past 2 years have been.
I was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer and given a prognosis of a couple of months to live, 3 months.
A doctor telling him the news in March of 2013, but he didn't accept it, fighting back against death so he can stick around for his 3-year-old daughter.
I would describe it as running a 100-mile race slowly up a mountain while fighting the toughest opponent you've ever fought.
Now he's running even farther, all the way to Washington, D.C. to raise money for 5 others fighting their own battles, while he continues to battle cancer himself.
The run starts right here at the track at Okeehele Middle School. Brian's done runs like this before. He says they're never easy, but during this one, he'll be facing some new challenges.
There's gonna be pain. There's gonna be some amount of injury.
And he'll have to make some detours back to Florida at least twice to get his cancer treatments. He says it's worth it, though, to support the others who are also fighting.
I live my life, work hard, pay it forward, help people when they need it.
Now, the co-founder of Brian's group, the Road Warriors, is also running. He's going all the way to Michigan. So far, the group has raised $50,000. Brian hoping to raise more to help 5 people cover their medical bills. And coming up, all new at 6, meet one of the people, a local 12-year-old girl who's benefiting from this run. Shannon?
What an amazing guy. Katie, thank you for that story. That'll do it for the Now South Florida News Channel 5 at 5. Begins right now.
Right now on News Channel 5.
Right now, all southbound lanes of I-95 near Donald Ross Road are back open. A woman was killed earlier this afternoon after stepping out of a car on the interstate. It happened in Palm Beach Gardens. FHP telling us a man and a woman traveling south of the Donald Ross Road exit were having some type of a domestic situation when they pulled over and she got out.
New developments at St. Mary's Medical Center in West Palm Beach. A panel of doctors that reviewed the hospital's track record suggested the medical center staff is not doing enough pediatric open heart surgeries to do them safely. In its second investigative story, CNN reports another baby died just 2 days ago.
Now we're hearing from an attorney who is representing several families who lost children. News Channel 5's Tanya Rogers is live at the law firm in West Palm Beach with new information. Tanya?
Well, that's right. We are live at West Palm Beach. Right behind me is the law firm. Now, this local law firm says they have filed two lawsuits on behalf of two families, and more lawsuits could be in the works. Today, we spoke with attorney Christian Searcy. He says last year he filed two lawsuits, but now he represents four families whose babies underwent surgery at the hospital. Just this week, a ninth baby died. And according to the CNN investigation from 2011, nine babies have died undergoing heart surgery, which is, they claim, higher than the national average. The attorney says a team of doctors from around the state evaluated the unit and reportedly gave the hospital some advice.
One of their overall recommendations was that St. Mary's Pediatric Heart Surgery Unit not accept any patients that were younger than 6 months of age.
Now, the lawyer told us that he could end up representing actually five families. So he said that number could climb as far as lawsuits, which would be against the hospital and also the doctor. Now, that doctor, we're being told, his deposition in one of those cases is scheduled for July 10th. We did try many times to reach out to St. Mary's Medical Center and also to the doctor to see if they wanted to comment, but they did decline commenting on camera. Reporting live, Tanya Rogers, WPTV News Channel 5.
When news of the deaths first broke this week, St. Mary's issued a statement. It said in part at the time, St. Mary's Medical Center has been working since 2011 to build a high-quality pediatric cardiac surgery program to serve residents of the Palm Beach and Treasure Coast communities. And it went on to say we're the only hospital providing this life-saving care between Orlando and Hollywood. The CNN story relies upon a selective presentation of cases and data, St. Mary's argued, to create a misleading perception of the program and Dr. Michael Black, a well-respected surgeon.
Less than 24 hours after we showed you the pushback on a school planning to open near the troubled 45th Street Flea Market, a twist that even city leaders didn't see coming. The charter school withdrawing their proposal just hours before today's planning and zoning meeting. News Channel 5's Brian Enten is at City Hall with reaction tonight. Brian?
Ashley, upset neighbors showing up here to fight this charter school, picking up an agenda right before the meeting and realizing that the charter school suddenly withdrew their proposal to open up on 45th Street. I just got off the phone with the president of the Florida Futures Academy Charter School. He says when they realized the zoning board was going to deny their proposal, they decided to back out. Neighbors upset the school for at-risk high school students wanted to open up in one of the city's most troublesome locations. According to city stats, there's been almost 200 calls to police in the last year from the flea market area right next to where that school wanted to open up.
Withdrawing the application, I think, is the right thing to do. I think it was the wrong place to think about putting a school. I mean, I had a lot of concerns about it being right next to the flea market.
The president of the charter school says they are already finalizing a new location and they will still open next year. He says there is a misconception out there about at-risk students. He says they're not criminals, they're not dangerous. Many times they might be pregnant students or students who are just working a full-time job and need an alternative school setting. We'll have more on this coming up at 6, including some people who are really hoping that school was going to open up on 45th Street. Live outside City Hall, Brian Enten, WPTV News Channel 5.
A battle brewing tonight in Green Acres over who should be responsible for public safety there. Right now, the city has its own police department, but that could be changing. News Channel 5's Jamel Lene joins us live from the public safety building there to tell us what it means. Jamel.
Well, it all comes down to money. Council members, they want to know if it's cheaper to let the sheriff's office patrol the streets of Green Acres. And so they've directed staff to look into that option. Now, right now, Green Acres has 51 officers, and they don't want to lose any of those cops. In fact, they hope to add six more to the streets. They've asked the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office to tell them what it would cost to have their officers report to Sheriff Bradshaw instead of having a city-owned department. Now, Councilwoman Judy Dugo is requesting several bids from PBSO. She says the department not only needs more officers, but they also need new cars and equipment. And she wants to know if it would be cheaper through PBSO. What's unclear at this point is how that affects Chief Michael Porath. Now, Dugo hopes the chief would become part of PBSO's leadership structure, but that's still unclear at this point. The bids, again, they are due by June 15th. PBSO, they can only tell me that they are working on these bids. Now, Green Acres is not the only agency that has let PBSO take over. Coming up all new at 6, we'll talk to another town council member or commissioner who says that it's all about perception, having the department or the sheriff's office in your town. And we'll talk more about that coming up at 6. That's the latest here in Green Acres. I'm Jamel Anae for WPTV News Channel 5.
Now, Storm Team 5 with South Florida's most accurate weather forecast.
Ooh, what a day out there. Beautiful sunshine, but we do have a few showers on the radar. They're inland, though, not at the coast. So if you're headed out this evening, great weather for you. Current temperatures are a mix of low and mid-80s. There's a little rain along 27 or close to 27 and trying to work in around Del Rey, but it's having a tough time doing it. The sea breeze has worked its way inland. Quiet at the coastline tonight. Current temps on the Treasure Coast looking nice, too. Here's your hour-by-hour forecast. I think you like it. Sunset coming up a little after 8 o'clock tonight and a few clouds. Chance for an inland shower through about the mid-evening. Does this great weather pattern last right into the weekend? We'll talk about it coming up.
Thanks. Right now, flash flooding hitting parts of Clay County, Missouri. Hard water consumed nearly everything there as the Fishing River's banks were lost in the flood. Roads were closed, many of them overwhelmed by the rushing water. People who could reach their homes and businesses had to fight through it, which in some cases climbed 10 feet higher than normal.
An autopsy is underway for the man who died days after Indian River County Sheriff's deputies found him unconscious in a transport van. That autopsy could take several weeks before any cause of death is officially revealed. Brad Martinez's family is also going to have a private autopsy done. You're looking at footage of what happened at the end of the ride back to the jail. Suddenly, paramedic teams gathering around Martinez. He'd been transported from court to jail. Sheriff Daryl Loris said he was okay when he was loaded into the transport van and said deputies did nothing wrong. Deputies found him unconscious, though. Once the eight-minute ride was over, he was rushed to a local hospital and removed this week from life support.
Fort Pierce police say the fear of being identified could be keeping witnesses from coming forward to help them find 2-year-old who was shot and killed, Michaela Burks. That happened last month. As Megan McRoberts reports, this all despite a big reward being offered.
Call it Philip Weiler's motivation to go to work every day.
Every day I look at that, and I look at that little girl.
A picture of 2-year-old Michaela Burks, shot and killed in a Fort Pierce shooting more than a month ago. He waits for the day a tip will lead to her shooter.
I would probably be on a high for quite a period of time.
Weiler is the tips coordinator for the Treasure Coast Crime Stoppers. He's looking for a lead.
It's tough. In Fort Pierce or other towns, people are afraid of retaliation.
That's why he's clarifying how tipsters are protected.
We just don't want to know who you are, but we do want your information.
If your tip comes in online or through a text,
it's emphasized, do not include your name.
It goes only to a center in Canada where numbers and IP addresses are scrubbed before information is given to law enforcement. Weiler says that's how your tip is protected from court orders.
They've scrubbed it, there's nothing there, but it's Canada. They're not going to honor a subpoena from the United States.
Phone calls go to a center in Texas where your name isn't needed. You're assigned a number instead to use to collect the reward. It's cash, meaning no paper trail.
The only way would be if the tipster announced it to someone.
Weiler hoping the community will trust their system and come forward for Michaela or any open cases.
I'm looking forward to the day I take that down.
Megan McRoberts, WPTV News Channel 5.
Now, Crime Stoppers contact information can be found on our website, WPTV.com, under the Seen As tab.
I am running for the presidency of the United States of America.
Scoot over. The list is getting longer now. There are 11. Rick Perry entered the Republican presidential race Thursday. The former Texas governor is having a redo of a 2012 bid that went poorly as he tumbled. After being briefly the frontrunner, he had a series of gaffes that contributed to that. He spoke in an airport hangar in the company of vets and hulking cargo planes like the one he once flew in the Air Force. Perry's one of the few veterans who will be running in 2016. Former Florida Governor Jeb Bush will be running for president in 2016. The worst kept secret, Mr. Bush plans to officially confirm his widely expected decision to enter the race for the nomination, and he'll do that coming up June 15th, an event south of Miami. In a tweet online, he said he'll make it official then. He said in recent weeks he's running, or all but said it, and even let it slip during a recent stop in Nevada that he's in the race.
The federal government released photos of the weapons the White House fence jumper had in his car. The pictures there show multiple guns, knives, and ammo that Omar Gonzalez was carrying when he was able to rush past guards, making it all the way to the East Room. The president and the first family were not home when the incident took place. Gonzalez pleaded guilty to entering a restricted building with a deadly weapon and assaulting a Secret Service agent.
I'm Jay Kashmir in the feed room. Developing right now, those familiar sobriety checkpoints may become a thing of the past. Instead, you might not be able to start your car if you don't pass a test. This all thanks to next generation auto technology trying to put the brakes on alcohol-related crashes. The U.S. Department of Transportation spelled out a program to lawmakers today that would require alcohol detection systems on all vehicles. Alcohol-related crashes claim 10,000 lives a year. Reporting from the feed room, back to you.
Jay, thank you. Rescue efforts continue at the site of that capsized cruise ship in China's Yangtze River. So far, 75 confirmed dead, more than 370 missing. The number of survivors remains at 14. Mostly elderly people were on board that ship, the Oriental Star. When it capsized, there are still so many rescue workers working on the hull, trying to cut their way in, all in the vain hope that they might yet find someone else alive. A decision, though, could soon be made also on how best and when to raise the ship from the river.
A new campaign aimed at keeping children safe from hidden danger near your television. What all parents need to know.
Speaking out, the parents of Josh Duggar talking about the controversy surrounding allegations that he fondled several girls, including his sisters, as a teen.
School may be out for summer, but that doesn't mean you can ignore signs like this. Hear the warning from police coming up.
And I headed out tonight. We're helping you plan for the evening. Storm Team Chief Meteorologist Steve Weigel has your most accurate weather forecast just ahead.
You're up this early because you want to squeeze a little more out of your day.
I'm busy during the day. I want to know what the traffic conditions are.
WPTV Time Saver Traffic with the only local chopper covering your neighborhood.
They're going to alert me of any traffic conditions so that I can replan my route to work.
A first-hand look at traffic jams so you don't have to guess.
You get an aerial view of the entire area.
Chopper 5, Time Saver Traffic, the only morning traffic team. Today on 5 on WPTV News Channel 5.
Personal injury attorneys have a bad reputation, but I'm proud that I've dedicated my career to fighting insurance companies that treat people unfairly. If the insurance company is giving you the runaround, call a lawyer you can trust.
Call me, attorney Craig Goldenfarb.
What's up now, Greg?
I heard about this healthy home thingy, so I thought I'd try to do one myself.
What you need is the Hewlett Healthy Home Service. It controls disease-carrying pests, guaranteed.
Where am I supposed to stick this?
Just call Hewlett. We have the expertise to fight any pest problem. Hewlett's Healthy Home program is pet-friendly and has no smelly sprays. That's the bug's final chapter, guaranteed. You know you're not a real doctor.
Yeah, I know. I just play one on TV. Just call Hewlett.
Just call Hewlett.
Mercedes-Benz of Palm Beach, where hospitality and friendly service is a family tradition. Mercedes-Benz of Palm Beach.
Some people go to Greece and bring back a statue. Me, I went to Greece and brought back a pizza.
The Greek pizza is back, a large for $12. And try our new garlic knots or our new cinnamon knots for just $5 more.
Better ingredients, better pizza. PapaJohns.com.
Aquarius is summer's most exciting new series.
You are unbelievable.
I can be a tad brusque.
Tonight, the hunt for one of America's most notorious criminals.
I'm Charlie Manson.
Has just begun.
Onward to glory, young buck.
New Aquarius, tonight, 9, 8 Central, followed by Hannibal on NBC. Hannibal earned a perfect score on Rotten Tomatoes, and it beat every other show to win Hulu's Best of the Best. Isn't it time you discovered Hannibal? Premieres tonight after Aquarius, here on NBC.
Storm Team 5 Weather Alert Days, only on WPTV News Channel 5.
I'm a third-generation lawyer in my family. Before my mom passed away, I promised her that I would dedicate my career to helping others. Help me make good on that promise. Call a lawyer you can trust.
Call me, attorney Craig Goldenfarb.
The parents of Josh Duggar speaking publicly about the controversy surrounding allegations that he fondled five girls as a teenager.
This was not rape or anything like that. This was like
touching somebody over their clothes. Mm-hmm. There were a couple incidents where he touched them under their clothes, but it was like a few seconds, and then he came to us and was crying and told us what happened.
Now, the Duggars explained most of the victims were family members. The scandal came to light in juvenile records released to a tabloid magazine. Jim Bob questioned why there hasn't been more attention focused on that leak.
New information on a dog found with a muzzle taped shut in South Carolina, a story that has gotten national attention. Vets were able to save most of Caitlin's tongue after 2 hours of surgery. They reconstructed the dog's jaw and took dead tissue in her lip and tongue, all part of the reconstructive effort. The man accused of taping Caitlin's muzzle shut has been charged with torture and animal cruelty. If convicted, he faces up to 5 years in prison.
Barbie kicking off her heels. Mattel has launched a new version of the iconic doll with adjustable ankles. For the first time ever, Barbie will be wearing either a high heel or a flat. Barbie now comes in 8 different skin tones, 18 eye colors, and 23 hair color options. To a consumer alert now, keeping your kids safe near the TV, the Consumer Product Safety Commission launching the nation's largest campaign to prevent furniture and TV tip-over deaths and injuries among young children. The campaign is called Anchor It and is a call to action for parents and caregivers. It includes broadcast PSAs, print PSAs, and an informational website, anchorit.gov, all of which outline the dangers of tip-overs and explain how easy it is to prevent them by anchoring furniture and TVs properly.
Trending now, a security researcher has found a flaw that lets hackers sneak into Apple Macs and remain undetected. The researcher says the problem is with Macs purchased 1 year ago or before that. When the Mac goes into sleep mode and then wakes back up, it allows its basic input-output system to be exposed to hackers, potentially. The system is the core program that brings the computer to life, and hacking into that system could let someone tamper with the computer's code.
Here's a health alert. Government health experts are backing an experimental drug intended to boost the female sex drive, but stress that it must carry safety restrictions to manage side effects like fatigue, low blood pressure, and then fainting as well. The Food and Drug Administration panel voted 18-6 in favor of approving Sprout Pharmaceuticals daily pill flibanserin on the condition that if its manufacturer develops a plan to limit safety risks. The positive recommendation is a major victory for a drug sometimes hailed as female Viagra, but which has been plagued for years by concerns about its lackluster effectiveness and safety issues. The FDA has twice rejected the drug since 2010.
Can't figure out where to go for that summer vacation? How about Alcatraz in San Francisco? The landmark has locked up the title of America's favorite landmark in TripAdvisor's annual Traveler's Choice Awards. The Golden Gate Bridge, a beautiful sight also in San Francisco, second place, while the Lincoln Memorial and Reflecting Pool tied for third in our nation's capital. As for the top landmark in the world, TripAdvisor says Angkor Wat in Cambodia topped that list. Nothing in Florida made the final list as you look at the Golden Gate.
Why don't you grab your friends and head down to the West Palm Beach waterfront tonight for the kickoff of Clematis by Night. Take a look here at this. The city of West Palm Beach posted this picture of the pool by artist Jen Liu into their Instagram. The fun starts less than an hour now at 6 and goes on until 10 p.m. Then tomorrow night, the city is throwing a so-called pool party with glow-in-the-dark lights, music, and food. And that starts at 7.
There's a list out ranking the safest cities in our state during a hurricane. And, of course, nowhere in our area cracked the top 10. Being on the coast, not necessarily surprising. HomeInsurance.com looked at NOAA-identified storms from 1965 to 2014. What do you see that isn't common there? The most storm damage and also the report of the most deaths and injuries. Then they compiled their list. First place, Leesburg. Second place to Orlando. Well inland. West Palm Beach checks in. Sanford just north of Orlando. On and on and on. West Palm Beach at 15. Stuart ranking 11th.
Now, Storm Team 5 with South Florida's most accurate weather forecast.
Yes, it's better to be inland when a hurricane is coming. And as far as coastal cities in Florida, Jacksonville is a pretty good place to be, too. The storms either turn to the north and hit the Carolinas, or they come into South Florida in our area, and they usually curve before they become a threat to Jacksonville, all the way up into Savannah. Pretty good area to be along the coastline of Florida. All right, quiet in the tropics tonight. We do have some rain on the radar, though, popping up in central and southern Palm Beach County. Little rain cells here and there, nothing significant. No lightning in these, and the current temperatures are a mix, a low and mid 80s. Another nice night on the way. Treasure Coast temperatures about the same. There are a couple of light showers just north of Sebastian and Vero that I'll watch into the evening, but overall it'll be very, very nice. If you have plans tonight, looking good. Sunset a little after 8 o'clock tonight. Warm. We'll keep the inland shower chance around through 9 and 10 o'clock tonight, and late overnight we cool off into the mid and low 70s. Really, really nice weather with just a few fair weather clouds, a little ocean breeze working in, and very mild. Some clouds pushing through too, so we'll call it partly cloudy tonight. The big range, torrential downpours through the Bahamas all the way down through Cuba and all connected to a system in Central America. This, in the short term, has really not much of an impact on our weather, but in the long term, it drifts north. Late Monday and Tuesday, some of this rain does work into South Florida, so we get some soakers. It's just going to take a few days. Vipercast keeps it pretty quiet through midnight into the early morning. There's 9 in the morning. When it's a fire up with a light shower along the coast, I wouldn't completely rule that out. And then that rain, and not much of it, but a bit, will work inland around the lake and then around Miami and Broward counties late afternoon and early evening. So it looks like a pretty good Friday night, too, if you're headed out. Daytime highs, we'll be warming up. We hit 87 officially today. It'll be the same the next couple of days, and then 88 for Sunday and Monday. And with more clouds around on Tuesday, we'll drop the temperature just a touch. Wave heights, not bad. Great for beach goers and boaters. Today was fantastic. Tomorrow looks good. Seas 1 to 3 and a light chop. Northeast winds again tomorrow. Unusual for this time of year, but it brings in some nice weather. Partly cloudy with an inland shower in 74 tonight. Heading out tomorrow also looks good. Just a slight shower chance, at least along the coast. A little bit better rain chances inland, 87. And the seven-day forecast, that includes the weekend. Nice for Saturday and Sunday. Warming up just a little bit. And as I said, better rain chances starting on Tuesday and Wednesday of next week.
Tough lesson. Three people facing charges of disturbing the peace during a graduation ceremony. How they ended up in trouble.
And all new at 5:30, the new technology that could tell you and your doctor every virus you've ever had.
Closed captioning on WPTV is sponsored by Bethesda Health.
The best in live music is at Arts Garage in Delray Beach. Enjoy exceptional jazz, blues, and Latin performances by Grammy-winning artists and emerging local stars. Bring your own whatever and make Arts Garage your after-work hangout or date-night destination. Visit artsgarage.org now for tickets.
Car accident?
People are talking about Steinger is going green.
After Maritza's accident, they got her $94,000.
Check this out. Steinger is going green got Rod $900,000.
Talk about getting paid.
800-561-1111.
Now at Empire Today, save big on new floors with our buy one, get two free sale. Buy floors for one room and get carpet, hardwood, or laminate for two more rooms free when you pay for padding and installation. Empire makes flooring easy. We bring samples to your home, give free estimates during your appointment, and professionally install your project right. So save big with Empire's buy one, get two free sale. Schedule now.
800-588-2300, Empire.
Today.
Enjoy your new shield.
Thanks.
How much did you spend on this?
Nothing. It was free, and they put it in just a day.
Well, if it was free and they put it in that fast, how good could it be?
You tell me.
She's got a Sloman Shield, the ultimate home security system. It's free, and yes, it's real good.
Okay, the system's great, honey. Please disarm it.
Why is it that when your heart skips a beat is when you feel most alive? Schumacher presents the perfect car for the Palm Beaches starting under $23,000. The 2015 Chevy Camaro, only at Schumacher.
Yeah, I like it, I love it, I want some more of it. I tried so hard,
I can't ride above it.
I don't know what it is about that little gal's loving.
summer joyriding when you win your choice of convertible, a 2015 Ford Mustang, Chevy Camaro, or Mini Cooper. Sunday, June 28th, free entry daily. Play more, be happy. That's how we roll at Isle Casino Pompano Park. Come
on! Car accident?
People are talking about Steinger, Isco, and Green.
When Deborah was injured in a car accident, the other driver refused to admit fault.
So Deborah called Steinger, Isco, and Green.
They got the truth.
And Deborah got the cash. $1 million.
800-561-1111.
The best in live music is at Arts Garage in Delray Beach. Enjoy exceptional jazz, blues, and Latin performances by Grammy-winning artists and emerging local stars. Bring your own whatever and make Arts Garage your after-work hangout or date-night destination. Visit artsgarage.org now for tickets.
Covering America, three people are facing charges of disturbing the peace during a graduation ceremony happening in Senatobia, Mississippi. The superintendent of the municipal school district there says it's not the first time outbursts have disrupted graduation ceremonies. The district encourages people to wait until all names are called before celebrating. The request is printed in the graduation program.
A former gubernatorial candidate in Vermont is causing some controversy by building a huge screen on her property. Ruth Dwyer has lived on her farm in Thetford for more than 40 years. But 2 years ago, things changed when a new home was built across the street overlooking her farm. So Dwyer planted cedar trees on her property line for privacy, but she also had a 60-foot by 24-foot screen built there as well as she waits for her trees to grow. Zoning officials have been fining her $200 a day since March.
Well, he can quit his day job if he wants. A Staten Island plumber is a multimillionaire now. Anthony Perosi won a $136 million Powerball jackpot. The drawing for the jackpot held on March 14th, but Perosi didn't check his ticket until his truck broke down. Realizing he needed some money to get it fixed, Perosi grabbed the ticket, which was pinned with a few others behind a pipe in his basement. And that's when he found out he won the jackpot. Perosi will split the lump sum of just more than $88.5 million with his son. And he says he'll continue to work a little and travel. We hope for him a lot. Congrats.
He has a few more friends this evening, I can tell you that.
I'm Jake Cashmere live in the newsroom. Coming up all new at 5:30. It is a mistake that cost several local drivers hundreds of dollars. The one thing they didn't do. Also, there's a lot of new construction going on, but in one area, it's the older buildings turning heads. Why they're becoming such a big draw among younger people. And it may be some of the most unusual cargo we have seen. And this is just the beginning of their journey. Find out whose landscape is about to be changing. Those stories and more when Shannon and I see you in just a few minutes from News Channel 5 at 5:30.
Business Report on WPTV is sponsored by your local Toyota dealers.
You decided to downsize your home. Then I said the contract should include an inspection, which revealed you weren't alone. Let a RE/MAX agent guide you. RE/MAX, dream with your eyes open.
Play-by-play, field reporter. Stadiums.
Who doesn't love watching sports? Well, the only thing more exciting than watching sports is being a part of the action, working in a career in sports broadcasting. And there's no better place to get the training you need than at Connecticut School of Broadcasting. For over 50 years, we've placed thousands of graduates in rewarding careers. Connecticut School of Broadcasting with two South Florida campuses in Miami and North Palm Beach. To find out more, call 1-800-TV-RADIO or visit GoCSB.com.
And your new dentures will be ready in a few weeks.
A few weeks? How am I going to eat?
With this.
I am not doing that.
Okay, let's try something new.
And your dentures will be ready Tuesday.
Taco Tuesday.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. At Aspen Dental, we're not just fixing teeth. We're fixing dentistry with dentures in days, not weeks. Just call 1-800-ASPEN-DENTAL.
Turn to the experts at Carrier and Cousins Air. Call Cousins Air for details today at 1-888-927-8003 or visit us at CousinsAir.com and keep cool.
Enjoy your new shield.
Thanks.
How much did you spend on this?
Nothing. It was free and they put it in just a day.
Well, if it was free and they put it in that fast, how good could it be?
You tell me.
She's got a Sloman Shield, the ultimate home security system. It's free, and yes, it's real good.
Okay, the system's great, honey. Please disarm it.
Just steps away from the water, relax, and enjoy the atmosphere and amazing food. Mulligan's, 12 weeks of summer, where kids eat free Monday through Friday, 3 to 9 p.m. Mercedes-Benz of Palm Beach, where hospitality and friendly service is a family tradition. Mercedes-Benz of Palm Beach.
You dreamt of a condo with a view. But then I showed you a suburb school, and the view of your daughter's future made a house look really cool. Let a RE/MAX agent guide you. RE/MAX, dream with your eyes open.
Live, local, from WPTV, this is News Channel 5 at 5:30. Local coverage you can count on.
I see a lot of speeders, and it does bother me.
Your children at risk, drivers ignoring important signs and being slapped with hefty fines.
It may be the last day of school, one of the last days of school in your community, but hitting the gas in a school zone is going to still cost you big. Yep, those zones remain live and in effect even in the summer months. News Channel 5's Charlie Keegan learned police are really watching, especially in Boynton Beach. Charlie?
Yeah, definitely. There's some students don't get much of a break. Really, summer classes start later this month. Then other schools will be busy hosting camps and giving away lunches and breakfasts to students. So schools remain a very busy place throughout the season, which means that you still need to obey the speed limits, which are posted here all summer long.
What did you do in Miss Horton's class?
Amy Aronowitz just picked up her kids from school for the last time this year.
It's bittersweet.
Her boys will spend summer with her, but plenty of other kids will be in school this summer. She worries drivers don't expect to see them.
I do see walkers and I do see bikers.
30.
Today, police officers had their lasers pointed at cars outside Citrus Cove Elementary, looking for speeders and reminding them the school speed zones apply even during the summer.
Reason I'm stopping, ma'am.
Sergeant Rich McNevin wants to prevent a scene he responded to a couple of years ago when a car hit a girl who was walking to school.
She literally stopped breathing in my arms while I was holding her.
The girl survived, but McNevin doesn't want any more close calls.
I want to get people to slow down and make sure the kids are safe.
Aronowitz hopes drivers get the point.
Huge message, because people think school's over and that's it. They forget about summer school.
And fines actually double if you're caught speeding in a school zone.